Okay, I've been trotlining a long time, and I have never done that.
Oh yeah, I love this, y'all. Trotlining and skips during gale force winds. Yeah, this is my favorite, y'all. Love this.
Just got the boat all packed up. Got the moon up there doing its moon stuff. Gonna go ahead and go out and lay these lines out and see if we can't catch a couple. All right, it's extremely early. I'm out on the water. I'm in the middle of getting my lines in the water. So that's where I am now. Hopefully it does about what it did yesterday. Even though I'm running 2-day-old bait today, you know, we'll see what happens here. Go ahead and get the rest of these lines in the water. Okay, well, the light down low, that's a sailboat. That one up there, I don't know what the heck that is. Let me stabilize this thing. The light at the bottom right is a sailboat. The one at the top, I don't know what the heck that is. It's moving. Weird.
All right, so you generally got a few hours after you lay your lines until you start running them just to do whatever, take a nap or whatever the heck it is you want to do. But I always see at least one shooting star every freaking time, which is pretty freaking awesome. I don't know exactly why, maybe because of the big open space, why you see them, maybe the time of not morning, I don't know, but you always see at least one. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and run all these lines. It's low tide, dead low tide right now. And I'm not gonna film running nighttime because I'm not expecting much at all. Like yesterday, nothing happened. Especially, it's even worse today because it's dead low tide. There's no freaking tidal action, but it's supposed to be pretty significant winds coming from the northeast, which hopefully will bring this tide in here, you know, and make it move in pretty quickly, and hopefully, you know, increase the likelihood of a crab coming across my line if there's higher tidal coefficiency. So hopefully that's how it goes. But yep, gonna go ahead and hop on this line. It's legal time now, so wish me luck. Alright, so that was my first run. Yesterday I got zero on my first run. I actually got one female, and you know, I can definitely tell at least one of them's a really good hard number one. I haven't checked the other two yet, but so I'm gonna throw the sook back. I've just been throwing sooks and peelers back, but you know, why not? You know, I'm not really catching enough of them to, you know. So that's where I am. Hop on the second line.
All right, so we got a pretty serious northwest wind, which is great for crabbing, not so much for crabbing, if you know what I mean. So, all right, on that round, I got 8. So I did 4 times better than my first round yesterday. Really nice experience. Hammer right here. I mean, the quality is incredible. This northwest wind pushes tide in here. And it's going to be horrible fighting it all day. You know, you got to do what you got to do. All right, I'm going to go ahead and film this next one. This next one should be okay, even though the tide's all the way down. You know, and it's not moving at all. Wind's blowing, I guess that's doing something, moving the craft around or something, I don't freaking know. So I'm gonna go ahead and hop on this next one.
Alright, this is the one, the first one I ran, I caught 4 on it. Yesterday, didn't catch any. Hopefully that didn't loosen it up too much. It might have. I was rolling. Uh-oh. All right, I think we can make it work. It was way too tight, even for nighttime on the first one.
Son of a gun might have barely been on the bottom. I don't know. But regardless, four crabs came up it, so. A lot of times if you loosen them and they seem a little bit too loose the first time you run them, the second time you'll kind of tighten it up once you after running it. Call a freaking white perch. Okay, I've been trot lining a long time and I have never done that. Not like that. Not. That's freaking crazy. I just freaking caught a white perch with a dip net crabbing. On film. That's freaking nuts. All right, going back, buddy. Okay, so that happened. I felt something hit the net. I'm like, oh, it must have been a crab swimming under the bait. I think there's one coming. I hope there's one coming. Freaking tide's dead low. I'm not expecting too much. There's one. Good. All this extra wind today and this little rig, I'm gonna have to run a little bit faster than normal. But the good thing is, see, I guess with the wind, when there's a lot of commotion going on, it causes a bunch of commotion on the surface of the water and in the water. And I think what it does to the crabs is it makes them less sensitive to danger. So you can run your lines a little bit more recklessly when it's blowing than when it's calm and still. And they'll still feed right. It's just kind of something I've noticed. All right, so two on that one. It was four last time, but it's dead low tide, so I think I caught just the very end of the outgoing tide on the first run. And that's why it did a little bit better, but.
There's a freaking deer over there next to my buoy. In the water with a baby. Something.
Alright, we got white caps rolling. I mean, it's just a bad situation of, if I run it one way, the sun's got me. If I run them the other way, the wind's messing me up. It's freaking, it's splashing the line. That water on that line is not good splashing on it. Not good at all. So, I'm gonna go ahead, I'm filming this one, running it. Alright, I'm running this one the opposite of how I was running it yesterday. I mean, it's messed up out here. I don't know what's worse, the shadow or the freaking line getting splashed. I think the shadow is probably worse if I can run it fast and keep that line below the water till it's real close to me. I do not like running the line like this. It's too bad. I'm gonna have to run this the other way with the shadow screwing me.
If I try to run it too slow, it's gonna drag my line too shallow. I love crabbing so much. It's so much fun. Yeah. I'm gonna have to run it the other way. This is just too stupid. All right, it's 7:30. I've got all my gear in the boat. I still got one more line to get. I ended up with about 2/3 a basket of good ones. Real pretty crabs. Little piece of junk. So, but yeah, there ain't no freaking way I'm getting the heck out of here. It's too crazy. I mean, I got freaking white caps and everything else rolling. And I mean, I'm in a protected spot right here. Like, it's bad. So thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe.